Welcome to an example on how to add two fractions with unlike denominators. The main thing to remember is when we add or subtract fractions, we must have a common denominator. The reason we need a common denominator is so that we add or subtract parts or pieces of the same size. So to add two fractions, once we have a common denominator, the denominator stays the same and we add the numerators. So looking at our example, we have 3/5 plus 1/2. Notice how we do not have a common denominator, and therefore we cannot add these fractions in their current form. If we're able to determine the smallest common denominator, it's called the least common denominator, which would be the least common multiple of 5 and 2, which is also the smallest number that's divisible by 5 and 2. And because 5 and 2 don't share any common factors, the least common multiple of 5 and 2 is going to be 10, so 10 is going to be the least common denominator. So what we want to do is rewrite 3/5 and 1/2 as equivalent fractions with denominators of 10. And because 5 times 2 is 10, we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of 3/5 by 2. And because 2 times 5 is 10, we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of 1/2 by 5. So now we know that 3/5 is equivalent to 6/10, and 1/2 is equivalent to 5/10. Now that we have a common denominator, or in this case the least common denominator, we can go ahead and add the fractions. The denominator stays the same, and we add the numerators. 6 plus 5 is equal to 11. So our sum is 11/10. Which does not simplify because the only common factor between 11 and 10 is 1, but because we have an improper fraction, let's also write this as a mixed number. This is an improper fraction because 11 is greater than or equal to 10. So to write the improper fraction as a mixed number, we divide the numerator by the denominator. So we have 11 divided by 10. There's 1, 10, and 11. 1 times 10 is 10. We subtract. We have a remainder of 1. So 11/10 equals 1 and 1/10. Let's also show this sum using the model below. If we define the rectangle as one whole, here we have a model for 3/5, here we have a model for 1/2. Before we can combine these two amounts, we want the parts or pieces to be the same size. So if we take each part that's equal to 1/5 here and cut into two pieces, here, 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 and so on. This shows 3/5 is equivalent to 6/10, which we have here. And if we take each piece in this model and cut it into 5 equal parts or pieces, this shows that 1/2 is equivalent to 5/10. And now that the pieces are the same size, we can combine these two amounts. And we see we have a total of 6 plus 5, or 11 parts or pieces, each piece equals 1/10, giving us a sum of 11/10. And let's go ahead and show the sum here. So we'll cut the rectangles into 10 equal parts or pieces. The first 10 pieces makes up 10/10, or one whole, and then we have one more part or piece that gives us one more tenth. So we have 1 and 1/10, or 11/10. I hope you found this helpful.